Greetings, Eric Backer from New Zealand. Thanks for coming back. The question here is, how do I know if I'm misdiagnosed for Candida? That's a very interesting question. And many times when I get a patient, they are absolutely convinced that they've got a Candida problem. And oftentimes they'll have digestive problems or skin problems or immune dysfunctions. They could have dysfunctions on multiple levels and they're convinced they've got Candida. They'll be following a Candida diet, they'll be taking Candida supplements, and then when we do stool testing, we find they've got no Candida at all. This happens in about half of all cases. Half! It's incredible but true. So we find no positive Candida culture at all in the stool. We find no dead yeast in the stool with microscopy. There's no Candida there. But there could be other forms of yeast there, right? Trichosporum, for example, is a yeast that we could find. So there are different forms. Geotrichum, there's another form of yeast. So there are many different forms of yeast that we could find, over and above Candida. Commonly, though, the person will have also bacterial issues, which they think are Candida, like Citrobacter fungi, like Pseudomonas, pneumoniae or agosa. So, there's different types of bacterial presentations that can affect people, and they can swear they've got a yeast problem, when in fact it could be a bacterial problem. So that bacterial problem could be SIBO, small intestinal bacterial overgrowth, or it could be a large intestinal bacterial overgrowth, or it could be a combination of both. It could be an infection, a problem affecting just a small portion of the small intestine. It could be a bacterial infection around the ileocecal valve, the valve connecting the small bowel with the large bowel. It could be a little bit of a bacterial or parasite problem around the appendix. So there are many different hotspots around the GI tract that could harbour different types of biofilm formation or infections, which could be one or multiple types of yeast, one or multiple types of bacteria, or the presence of parasites, bacteria and yeast, or just parasites without bacteria, et cetera, et cetera. So all of those combos are possible. The other scenario could be is just purely a lack of beneficial bacteria. So stool testing will actually reveal what is going on inside. And that's why I'm always a big fan of stool testing and why we've performed thousands of these tests in our clinic. And we've now come to realize that roughly about half of people who swear they've got Candida, in fact, haven't got it at all. So what do? You would just treat for Candida, because the treatment for many different types of bacteria is very similar in their overgrowth stage as it is for Candida treatment. That's what I would recommend that you do. And if in doubt, check it out with a stool test. Thanks for tuning in.